So what I thought I'll do today is actually look back on the year. Because I realize that there's always a deluge of information coming towards you from Amazon. You know, we are not a company that actually uses this event to make all announcements for the coming year, and that maybe even delay that for 2 years before we actually give that into your hands. Yeah? We are a fast-moving, innovative company, and each team has the responsibility of innovating on behalf of you guys. That feedback that you give us, those teams actually, during the year, modify their roadmap to make sure that they really address the biggest pain points of our customers. And so we really, really want your feedback. So I'll look back a bit on the year, about what were the big things that you guys asked us for in the past year and that we've delivered on. And also, I'll then go deeper into a few things that really excited me. The kind of things that we delivered in the past year, like cloud formation and Beanstalk and the new VPC and things like that. Yeah. So for those of you who really knew, actually Amazon has three very distinct different businesses. One is the retail business. I hope you guys are all retail customers as well. But we have this second business, which is the seller business, which is on one hand actually selling on the Amazon platform as a third party, but also have this very large enterprise e-commerce platform on which we run some of the world's largest e-commerce operations. Not just Amazon.com and our 7 international websites, but also Target.com and Marks & Spencer's and Mothercare and a whole range of other very large e-commerce operations. That platform is much larger than what Amazon.com itself needed. And so that kind of drove us also into building an infrastructure layer underneath there that could support this very large scalable business. And that became eventually towards the outside world what we now know as the Amazon Web Services, yeah, or the cloud, as many will call that now. And so we treat these as three very different businesses. Yeah, one is consumer, one is sellers, and one is developers and IT infrastructure folks. Yeah, so on the AWS side, this is our mission, yeah? To enable businesses and developers to use web services to build scalable, sophisticated applications. That was the mission when we started this. Of course, it looks much bigger now. When we really started this, we were focused on young, innovative businesses where we thought that if we could only open up our own infrastructure for everybody else to use, then some kid that will be sitting in a dorm room in Cornell with the idea for the next Google or for the next Amazon would actually have the infrastructure to get off the ground. Of course, it took enterprises only about 2 months after that we launched to figure out that this was a way too good deal for them as well. And they've been our largest customers ever since. So these two groups kind of keep themselves in balance on our platform. But also, at the same time, you have to realize that actually enterprise and young businesses, those two lines are kind of blurry. Yeah, where in the past, for example, data analysis would be the domain of enterprise applications or of large enterprises. These days, there isn't a young business that starts off that doesn't start at the beginning with also data collection and data analysis. On one hand, often to just feed their existing application and make it better for their customers, or often also as a sort of secondary revenue stream to be able to fund their business. So the whole world of what actually is cloud doing, what actually is the enterprise doing, and what are young businesses doing, those two are really blurry. And actually, cloud powers most of these. Yeah? So I won't go too much into these. If you're new to AWS, there's a whole track on this later on. If you're already familiar with that, there's lots of things going on, a deep dive later. The thing is that I can promise you that next year, this slide will look different again. Many new features and probably some new services around this as well. So I won't spend too much time on it.